have to see the limits of knowledge, but can we give a priority at least with ourselves, with our children and the children whom we are going to come across, relating to what is really human relationship? I doubt where, how much priority we give to that while talking to a child. We talk to a child about mathematics and geography and games and sports and politics, but what is this unique human relationship? I think we need to give a priority to it.
And first time, because of organic farming, farmers have to think. And they have to think, they cannot think of a universal solution which if they apply on their field, some other farmer can apply somewhere else. Because all the farmers are having diverse type of plots. They have diverse inclinations. They have, different types of soils. Some of them will be clay, some of them will be sandy, some of them will be whatever it is. And they are in different areas. So some of them will be in the rainfall area, some of them will be in the dry area, and so on. So automatically, the laboratories for experimentation begin to get multiplied. And you have that many hundred farmers who are all doing experiments on their own. And they begin to work out different techniques. In the beginning, they fail a little bit. And then finally, they get their priorities right. Instead of thinking that it is only a matter of putting some compost in the soil or putting some earthworms in the soil or whatever it is, they understand that the first thing that you've got to do is to see whether the soil is living or dead. And if you get your soil living, then everything automatically follows. And over the last 5 to 6 years, that's what the Tamil Nadu farmers have done. They have worked out a series of techniques for restoring the life in the soil. They're not bothered about nutrition in the soil, they're not bothered about putting NPK in the soil, they're not interested in making money out of the soil. All that they are interested in saying is, how do you maintain a soil which is so full of organisms, the moment you put your hand inside and take it out, it will have organisms, and secondly, it will be so soft that you can put your hand inside and you can take out the mud.
Dham, dham, iske baad dusra instrument yaha laga hua hai. Iske liye hame karna hoga dham, dham, dharam, dharam. Dada, dudu. 1, 2, 3, stop.
For me, learning societies, it's not about good schools or bad schools. I think it's about multiple worlds, multiple possibilities, multiple expressions, to borrow from Vivek, multiple publics, that, and the beauty that exists in the world, and how do we reclaim that beauty and that diversity.
It's a protest against the dominant development paradigm. You better rethink about development. For you, it's big projects. For you, big infrastructures, big mines, big alumina industry. But for us, it's not big. The small things we have with us, we want to protect that. Our forefathers have survived on it. Our succeeding generation will also survive on it.
At this stage, there is a sense of broken dreams with our generation, and it especially came through very bitterly, very strongly with what happened in Gujarat this year. I have come out of partition. Saw it all and thought we had left it behind us. There it was. There it is. I went there. And that just doesn't go away. What is happening to us? What are we doing? Why are we not able to stop it? Well, one is holding this thread, these new connections, these old connections. All that we value is in danger. That's the way I feel. We have to, this morning, the thought uppermost in my mind was, what is the meaning of human life, to be alive today in this day and age? That was the question before Gandhi at the beginning of the last century. I think we can do nothing less than that question before us. What is the purpose of our lives? Whatever I ask myself, whatever 5-10 years I have, what is the purpose of my life? What is the mission? What is the work remaining to me in this age with all its agonies? It will not do to wish it away. There are Holocaust type of things that are before us.
Because this is not just about a school or a learning society. It's about how we want to live our lives. It's about resistance in a much broader context. And it's about taking action. And if we talk about people's movements, well, who are the people? I mean, who are we talking about? We're not only talking about those groups that are out there and far away from us. We're talking about us. And if we're going to make suggestions about what needs to be done, I think we need to be doing it. And for me, it's not really about going to policymakers and saying, this is what we think. Well, you know, that's the action we take all the time, and you know, we know what happens with that. If it's about people's movements, we don't need anybody's approval. It's about what we do. It's about how we act. It's about how we live.